What's up guys, I'm Phoenix Master 1 and welcome to this week's Resonant Battles free to play guide. So last week we were demoted to Interval 19 and it seems like we have hit that paywall basically, where if you don't have a harmonic hero, you're basically gonna be in Interval 19.5. So this week we are actually going up to Interval 20 it seems, and I've got a pretty easy solution here to follow. So this is gonna be my team, and this is pretty flexible. You could easily use Plagian Dorothea with this team, as you could see by the Tethys being the placeholder. So the first thing that we have is Ross. This could be replaced by any kind of Axe unit who can take out La Rochelle. This could be Brave Ephraim, this could be Kallak who has got Brave Axe. So this could be pretty flexible spot here, and you just need to have like pretty decent attack stat to just take out La Rochelle, which is not really all that hard. My Ross is plus attack, but you could easily run like attack plus 3 or death blow 2 here and slot it to get the same power, and it doesn't really matter too much in the long run. So you could have attack defense solo as the sacred seal here, and basically have Brave Axe. You know, it's pretty flexible. You could use Ross and all of the other Axe units, and make sure this unit has got Smite. Ross already comes with Smite, so that's pretty good, and that's why I'm using him. And then we've got Carmack, the MVP for this solution. Now this could be any Lance unit, this could be your Tana, this could be Trevant, this could be Valter, this could be really any kind of Lance unit who has got a Brave Lance and Lunge. That's basically it, because they're gonna be able to hit at least this much attack, and they can easily take out the Thieves using that. So make sure to have Deathblow on them. Slotty is open to improvise if you want to have more attack stat for the higher intervals, so make sure to do that. So these two spots are pretty flexible, and it's up to you which units you want to use them as long as they can fulfill that role. Lunge is going to be pretty helpful, and then we have got Dancer Eldigan. So everyone does have him, he's a pretty recent unit. You don't really need Wings of Mercy here, instead we're going to be using Escape Route. Escape Route is way more available than Wings of Mercy, so this does make it easy. And Courtly Candle is going to be helping quite a bit. You could have Drive Attack on a Sacred Seal. And if you're even in the lower intervals, this is not really going to be necessary, but especially if you're in the higher intervals, every point of attack really helps, so you could have Drive Attack here. And Slot C and Slot A are open for improvisation as well as the Weapon Refine. And the final unit we have is a Placeholder unit. This could be literally any unit, and it should be fine. So I'm using a Tethys here. I have unequipped her Dance, and that's for a reason. So in Resonant Battles, you can only use one Dancer. If you use another Dancer, then you're going to have to pay penalty a few points. However, if you unequip their Dance, you're no longer going to be paying that penalty. So this could be used to our advantage, and if you have a Plagian Dorothea, just use her in place of Tethys, have her with Attack Tactic Sacred Seal, and basically unequip your Dance. I'm saying this again, unequip the Dance on this unit. This is just a placeholder unit. I'm just using her to show that you're not going to be suffering any kind of penalty, and we're still going to be ending up with 400 points, which is the max points we could get with this team. So that is going to be my free-to-play solution. Pretty flexible team overall. If you're in the higher intervals, I do have a lot of options open up for improvisation, so you could easily do that. And with that said, let us begin. So from FE4 and Sacred Stones, we don't really have too many good units which you could use on this kind of map. So we're going to be starting off with La Rochelle. Now I know if she was not a holy woman, she would beat us senseless, but because she's not going to beat us up, we're going to beat her up with Ross with Brave Axe. So you basically need to take her out with your Brave Hit, and that's why, you know, any kind of Axe unit can work. I'm going to dance up your Ross.
It'll be done.
Have your Carmack over here, and then smite your Carmack or any kind of Lance Flyer with your Ross. Tethys is just going to be hanging around here. Tethys basically needs to give the attack tactic support to Ross to make sure that he could take out La Rochelle. And because of Courtly Candle's damage reduction, we can actually survive this Innis even without Iod Shield Sacred Seal. On the higher intervals, you could easily use a Weapon Refine to gain some extra HP or even use some kind of Slotted skill, so it should be pretty good. And we're now going to be smiting Carmack even further.
Indeed.
And we can just take out this obstacle here. Use Escape Route on Eldigan. You just need Escape Route 1.
Understood.
Because Innis has weakened down Eldigan quite a bit. And because of Brave Lance, we can easily take out this Red Thief quite comfortably. Drive Attack Support does help you over here. And now you can just walk away with your Tethys. My Ross is minus defense, but with attack defense solo, he can still survive Innis when he's going to be triggering his iceberg. So if my minus defense Ross can survive, you know, any other unit can definitely do it. Alright, so now we're gonna be using our infantry boots here, which we got the last turn by killing that red thief. So we're gonna use that and then take out this red thief. And we get a pretty exact lethal on this red thief. So I believe on interval 20, you would definitely need to run like death blow here on his Slotty or something like that to get some extra attack. Now that we have Dancer's Veil, we can just use that on Carmack. And that is gonna be refreshing him. So what we could do is basically go over here. Because of the infantry boots, we can have the extra movement. Go behind Carmack and then dance him up so that we can stop this thief from escaping. You can basically just go over here with your Ross and break that obstacle. Doesn't really matter too much what you do here. And we can basically just take out this blue thief over here pretty easily. Get the lightning charm, which is going to be pretty helpful. So we're gonna use that. There is really no healer on the opponent's squad, so we should be good. And we're trying to stop this red thief over here, who does have the special blade, but we just want him to not escape, so we can just take out this red thief like that. Get the fortifying horn, which is pretty good. And we can just take out this red thief eventually with Eldigan. Eldigan is just gonna be checkmating this green thief. And not gonna be letting him escape.
It'll be done.
So this is pretty good. It is gonna take few turns, of course, but you can basically just attack like this. And next time you're gonna be able to take out that green thief. So we're gonna be using the fortifying horn now. Using that, we can easily take out this green thief, get the special blade, and now you have your special charged up with that special blade on Trevant and Carmack. They do have Ignis, so we can now just take them out. And that is gonna be the free to play solution for this week.
Foes must fall. It's simple.
Yep, it is pretty simple. Well put by Carmack. So that is gonna be the Resonant Battle solution. Everyone falling to a 4-star Carmack. And as you saw, I got the 400 score right there, even with Tethys. So as long as you unequip Dance on your Dancer, on your second Dancer or Tethys or Police and Dorothea, you're not going to be facing any kind of penalty, which is really sick. So keep that knowledge in mind for future, because it's pretty flexible to use like Police and Dorothea as just a placeholder unit here. So hope you all enjoyed this video, and I hope this was helpful to you guys. Make sure to share this video with your friends, because we are going up to interval 20 pretty easily, it seems. And I want to thank all of my team members for their constant support. If you enjoyed, then please be sure to leave a like and a comment, helps me tremendously. And be sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell, because YouTube sub boxes are about as functional as my level 1 Tethys was on this map. So with that said, I'll see you guys next time. Thank you so much for watching and have a great day.